Good morning, Andy. Here we are going to discuss about the reciprocity theorem. The first of all, reciprocity theorem statement. In any linear bilateral network, if a single voltage source VA in branch A produces a current IB in branch B, then if the voltage source VA is removed and inserted in branch B, then it will produce a current IB in branch A. Then the ratio of the response to the excitation is the same for the two conditions mentioned above. Then this is called the reciprocity theorem. That means here, if the voltage source is in branch A, it will produce the current in the branch B. Then if the voltage source has been replaced in the B branch, then also it will produce a current in the branch A. Then the ratio of the response to the excitation, that means if the voltage will be given, then the response will be current. So if the current is given, then the response will be voltage. So simply, whatever may be the response to the excitation, it will be equal in the both the cases. So then the circuit is said to be following the reciprocity theorem, or otherwise it is not following the reciprocity theorem. So with an illustration we'll see now. So here you can observe that in the first case, A dash voltage source is there. So by means of this voltage source, there is a current is producing in the BB dash. If the voltage is producing the current in the BB dash, then the ratio of the response to the excitation in this case is I divided by V for the first case, case 1. For the case 2, here you can observe if the voltage source has been replaced here, due to that voltage source also, there will be some current will be produced in the branch AA. Here also you need to calculate the ratio of the response to the excitation is nothing but I divided by V. In both the cases, case 1 and case 2, if you are getting the response to the excitation, that means the current to the voltage, then if both are equal, then the theorem is said to be following the reciprocity theorem. Coming to the examples, okay, here we are seeing the examples to verify the reciprocity theorem for the network below. Here you can observe that there is a 20 voltage source he has given, and 2 ohms are the series branch networks, and 3 ohms and 2 ohms and 2 ohms are the shunt branch elements. So you need to calculate by means of 20 voltage source there is a current is flowing in the CD branch, that you can you need to get 2 ohm branch current. So for that purpose, if in the case 1, what is the case 1? In the case 1, you need to calculate the total current by means of the total current by means of the current division principle. You need to calculate the current through the 2 ohm resistor. And after that, what you need to do? You need to replace the 20 voltage source in the CD branch, that will be connected to CD branch, and then the current is, you need to calculate the total current here also. By means of the total current, the current by applying the current division principle, you need to calculate again in the case 2, if the current through the branch AB also you need to calculate. So if the in the both cases the current through to the voltage, the ratio is the same, then this network is following the reciprocity theorem. So here this is the problem solution. So here first of all, what you need to find out? You need to find out the total current. In order to find out the total current, what you need to find out? First of all, the total resistance you need to find out. Here in which way you can find out the total resistance? Here whatever may be the branches, okay, whatever may be the branches, here you can observe this 2 ohm is in parallel with the 2 ohm, and that is in connected with the 2 ohm, and next that is in connected in parallel with the 3 ohm, and then that is connected with the 2 ohm is in series. So here you can observe this by means of that one, here what you can get, 3.5 ohms is the total resistance you can get. And of course the total current, what is the total current? Total current is equal to 20 divided by 3.5, that will be is equal to 5.71 ohms you can get. So here this is the total current, but you need to calculate the current through the branch, CD branch you need to get. You got the value of the total current. So by means of the current division principle, what you can get, current division principle, what you can get, 1.43 amperes you can get. And next for the case, this is the case 1 and case 2. Case 2, in the case 2 what you need to do, by applying the reciprocity theorem, interchanging the source and the response, then automatically by interchanging the source and the response, that means voltage source will be coming to your CD branch and current source is coming to your AB branch. Then the total resistance is equal to, what is the total resistance here also? 2 ohms is in parallel with the 3 ohm, is in series with 2 ohm, and again it is parallel with the 2 ohm, and again it is series with your 2 ohm. So that's why the total resistance is equal to 3.23 ohms. So from that, what you can get, the total current is equal to the total voltage divided by total current 20 volts divided by 3.23. That will be is equal to 6.19 amperes you can get. Yeah, this is the total current. So but you require the current through the branch AB, not total current. So for that one, what you need to do, by means of the current division principle, okay, by applying the current division principle here, this is the total current you can get 6.19 amperes, and current in the branch AB is I is equal to 1.43 amperes you can get by means of the current division principle. So here also the ratio of the response to the excitation, that means input current to the input voltage, will be given by will be given by 20 divided by 1.43, that will be is equal to 13.99. that means in the both the cases the ratio will be the same. So that's why here this network is following, is said to be it is following the reciprocity theorem here. Hence the reciprocity theorem has been verified. So next case, and so for the network here, I am not repeating, this is the YouTube link directly. If you want to repeat, again play the repeat button, okay. So that's why I am not repeating the what I may be the cases. So here, and anyway, once again, just first problem I will say. So what is the conclusion here? Fatafat, I will say once again, just to verify the reciprocity theorem for the network. First, in the case one, you need to calculate the total current, and by means of the total current, you need to calculate current by means of the current division principle. You need to calculate the current through the 2 ohm resistor, and current through the 2 ohm resistor, and the ratio of the response to the excitation you need to calculate. And after that also, yeah, in the case 2 also, you need to calculate the total current by means of that one current division principle you need to apply. In that case also, you need to calculate the current division principle, the total current you need to calculate. And then after that, the ratio of the response to the excitation you need to calculate. If both are equal, then it will be following the reciprocity theorem. Here, yeah, this is the network, okay. And next for the second case, and the second case here, you can observe the network. What is the network? For the network, find out the ammeter current when battery is at A and ammeter is at B. When the battery is at B and ammeter is at point A, that means here for the first case, what is the first case? Ammeter current you need to find out, that means when the battery is placed at A point, and you need to calculate the current through B point. And if the battery has been replaced for B point, and you need to calculate the current at the point A also. So the ratio also you need to calculate. That means here, in which way you can calculate here, this is the problem. 36 volts he has given, and 4 ohm resistor, 2 ohm resistor, and 12 ohm resistor, 3 ohm resistor, and 1 ohm resistor. You need to calculate by means of the 36 volts battery, you need to calculate the current through the this 1 ohm resistor. So in which way, we will see now. Here also the same concept. In the case 1, you need to calculate current, and the ratio of the response to the excitation you need to calculate. And for the case 2 also, you need to calculate, that means by replacing case 2 also, ratio of the response to the excitation you need to calculate. So here, first of all, before going to the current division principle, you need to calculate the total current. What is the total current? Battery current is equal to total voltage divided by total resistance will be gives you the total current. 36 divided by 9 will gives you 4 amperes. And ammeter current, what is the ammeter current? 4 into, that means by means of the current division principle, 4 into 12 divided by 16, that will be is equal to 3 amperes you can get. So next one, ammeter current you need to calculate, that is the case 1. And in the case 2, what is the case 2? In the case 2, you need to replace your voltage source, and then after that, what you need to find out, the total current you need to find out, and again you need to find out the current by means of the current division principle, you can calculate that one. So here also that will be like that. And here this is the battery current, okay. Here this is the battery current. Battery current will be gives you 36 divided by 8, that will be is equal to 4.5 amperes, and ammeter current you need to find out by means of the current division principle, 3 amperes you can get. So in the both the cases, the ratio of the response to the excitation will be the same. So he told that the in the problem he has given that you need to calculate that total resistance. So transfer impedance you need to calculate. That transfer impedance is nothing but simply voltage divided by current. That will be gives you 36 divided by 3 amperes. That will be is equal to 12 ohms. You can get up to reciprocity theorem. So coming to next theorem is compensation theorem. Okay, compensation. What is the compensation theorem statement? The compensation theorem statement is it states that in any linear bilateral the linear bilateral network may be replaced by a voltage source of the magnitude V is equal to the current passing through the element multiplied by the value of the element provided the current and voltages in other parts of the circuit remains unaltered. That means, yeah, if you are taking one circuit, you need to calculate one current. Okay, after if you want to insert one resistance, then first of all you need to calculate by means of that one, you need to calculate one current, that current multiplied by that delta R you need to take as a voltage source, then also you need to find out one current. That difference of the first current and this current you need to calculate. That much of the current is nothing but your compensating current. Once again I am repeating, first of all for the given circuit you need to calculate one current in the respective branch. Suppose if you want to insert one delta R, that means some change in the resistance you need to change, then you need to calculate how much will be the current you need to inject in order to compensate that resistance you need to calculate. So for this purpose also what you need to do, whatever may be the case one current, that current multiplied by this delta R will be taken as the voltage source. That voltage source will gives you by means of that voltage source also you need to calculate one current. Okay, that current will gives you the case 2 current. That means case 2 current and case 1 current difference. Okay, that difference between the case 1 current and case 2 current will gives you the compensating current. That means in the case 1 current is the direct current, but in the case 2 current it will be the delta R current. You have taken delta R multiplied by current value you have taken, that means voltage source. So that's why here the difference of these two will gives you the compensating current. Here this is the theorem statement, and with respect to one example we'll see now. Here you can observe that in the network he has given, that means case one you can observe that network he has given the total current multiplied by total resistance he has given, and next that means you need to calculate the voltage IV is equal to I into R, and of course already I you have found. And in the case 2 you need to, in the case 2 what he has given delta R you need to inject. Okay, if you want to inject delta R, then also you need to calculate one current. So by means of the one voltage source, here you can observe that in the diagram I into delta R will be taken as a voltage source, and delta R will be the change in the resistance. That means in order to compensate the drop due to the delta R, you need to inject the current supplied by the I into delta R. So that is the case. So here finally what you need to do, this case 2 current and case 1 current will be the difference of these two currents you need to calculate. That current can be called as the compensating current. That theorem is known as the compensation theorem. So here I am taking one example. Determine the current flowing in the ammeter having a 1 ohm internal resistance connected in series with a 3 ohm resistor. Yeah, that means here you can observe in the diagram what he has given in the diagram. 10 voltage source he has given, 4 ohms he has given, 6 ohms he has given, 3 ohms he has given. For this one, what is the case 1? In the case 1, you need to calculate by means of the 10 voltage source, how much current is coming through the 3 ohm resistor you need to calculate. That is the case 1 current. And after that, case 2 current you need to calculate. What with a 1 ohm resistor, he has told that ammeter having the 1 ohm internal resistance, that 1 ohm internal resistance can be taken as the delta R that you need to inject in series with this 3 ohm resistor. Then you need to calculate the I into delta R. What is the I here? I is the case 1 current, and delta R will be this 1 ohm resistor. I into delta R will gives you the voltage you need to inject in this 3 ohm resistor. That means by means of this one also you need to get the case 2 current. This case 2 current and case 1 current will gives you the difference of these two. Okay, this difference of these two currents will gives you the compensating current. In this way, you need to calculate the compensation current. So, in which way we will see now. So, with respect to this example, here, first of all, in the case 1, what is the case 1? The current flowing through the 3 ohm resistor you need to calculate, that will give you 1.11 ampere. In which way you can find out this current? Here, simply by means of the current division principle you can apply. So, by means of the current division principle you can get the 1.33 ohms, you can get 1.11 ampere you can get. And in the case 2, next what you need to do? If we connect an ammeter, having 1 ohm resistance to the 3 ohm resistance branch, there is a change in the resistance. That means whatever may be the delta R, that delta R you need to add to the 3 ohm resistance, and then after that you need to take one voltage. That voltage can be given by the V is equal to I into delta R. That means here the changes in the currents in the other branches then result as a, if a voltage source of the voltage I3 into delta R 1.11 into 1, where this 1.11 will be coming here. This is the case 1 current. What is the case 1 current? 1.11, that 1.11 into delta R, that will be is equal to 1.11 volts, which is you need to inject into that 3 ohm resistance. That means in this way you need to calculate the case 2 current also. What is the case 2 current? Here also current due to 1.11 voltage source has been calculated. I3 dash is also gives 0.17 amperes. And this current is opposite to the that current, whatever may be the this thing. So remaining things, so what you need to do? Here you need to calculate the difference of the current. What is the difference of current? The first current, case 1 current, and case 2 current will give you 1.11 minus this 0.17 will give you 0.94 amperes. Here amperes you can remember, I have written 0.94 ohms, but 0.94 amperes you can take, please. And next, this is the compensation theorem. And next concept is duals and duality. Okay, next concept is duals and duality. Dual and what is meant by dual means, suppose if a network is analogous to the another network, then the terms, whatever may be the elements, that means resistor, inductor and capacitor, those will be, those will be replaced by their analogous elements. So that means by means of the equations, without changing, without changing the properties of the equations or without changing the properties of the network, so we will replace inductor and capacitor and resistor and conductor, capacitor and inductor in such a way that the equations and properties should be the same. So here that concept, this total concept is known as the duality. And those terms, whatever may be the resistors, are changing into conductances, inductance are changing into capacitances, capacitances are changing into inductance. So these can be called as the dual terms. And what are the dual terms are also we will see now. So here you can take the one example. Here you can observe that total voltage source, he has given that voltage V, and next resistor R and inductor and capacitor he has given. By means of the KVL, what you can get? I into R plus L into dA divided by dt plus 1 by C into integral of I dt will be the capacitor voltage. That will be is equal to total voltage. That means here simply we have taken the KVL equation. KVL equation, what is the KVL equation? Total voltage is equal to I R plus L into dA by dt plus 1 by C into integral of I dt. That will be is equal to total voltage of V. And in next case, here that will be converted into, voltage source is going to converted into current source, and resistor is converted into conductance, and inductor is converted into capacitance, capacitance is converted into inductor. But here the combination is changing. Here all the, in the first case, all the elements are connected in the series, you can observe. And next, what is the second case? In the second case, you can observe all the elements are connected in the all the elements are connected in the parallel. Okay, that means here the dual of the series connection is nothing but the parallel connection. Dual of the parallel connection is nothing but it will be connecting into the series connection. So simply you can remember all these things. And next, here finally you can see here the equation. Here you can observe in the diagram total differential equation I into R plus L into dA by dt plus 1 by C into integral of I dt, that will be is equal to V. This will be converting into the equation without changing the properties. So voltage is equal to, here you have applied the KVL. There in the second circuit, what you need to apply? There you need to apply the KCL, which is nothing but I is equal to G into V. That means at the nodal analysis, by means of the nodal analysis, you can observe G into V. That means here if you observe the voltage, nodal voltage will be taken as the V. Then I is equal to G into V plus C into dV divided by dt for the capacitor plus 1 by L into integral of I dt will be the inductor current. Okay, here the you are writing the total current is equal to the individual sum of the current. So here in the LHS, the total voltage is equal to the individual sum of the voltage drops you have taken. These are the dual terms. Here such space, what are those space? Such space, you can observe that dual terms are, if for the current you can take the voltage, for the open circuit you can take the short circuit, for the inductor case you can take the capacitor, for the resistor case you can take the conductor, and next for the series connection you can take the parallel connection, and for the voltage source you can take the current source, and for the KCL you can take the KVL. And of course, vice versa also will be applicable. Voltage source key, for voltage source, you can take the current source. And next for the short circuit, for the open circuit. And next for the capacitor, you can take the inductor. For the conductor, you can take the resistor. And for the parallel connection, you can take the series connection. And for the current source, you can take the voltage source. And for the KVL, you can take the KCL. Like this way, you can go. So what is the procedure? Procedure, you can observe that here. In each loop of a network, place a node. That means whatever may be the loop he has given, you need to place one each node, and outside also you need to place one node that can be called as the reference node. And that means if there are two loops, then you can put one each dot for the each loop, and outside also you need to put one dot that can be called as the reference node. And next, draw the lines connecting the adjacent nodes of the through each element. That means you need to draw the lines connecting the nodes of the with respect to nodes, that means with respect to elements, you need to connect each element and add to the reference node. That means for the network, if you get the internal one node is there, outside also one node is there. That means you are connecting internal node to the outer node with respect to the element. Okay, with respect to the element, in which way we will see now. Just wait. Okay, also to the reference node by placing the dual of each element. And of course, at this time, what you need to do? You need to place dual of the each element also in the line passing through the original elements. This is the procedure. And next, coming to this example here, he has given that. What he has given? Here he has given that the current source he has given, and next it will be connected resistor R1 and capacitor C, and next inductor L and R2 also he has been connected. Here you can observe the connection. That means for the current source, what are the dual terms you need to replace? For the current source you need to replace. And first, what is the procedure? There will be the two loops now. For each loop you need to place each two nodes. Okay, for one loop you need to put one node, and for the second loop you need to put and the second node, and for these two nodes you need to put one reference node also. And next, here after that, what you need to do for each element, you need to draw one by means of the connecting the internal node to the outer node, that means reference node, by means of the drawing the each element dual element. Okay, for each element dual element also you need to draw. That means for the current source, what is the dual element? Voltage source will be the connection. And next, for the resistor you need to put the conductor, and next for the capacitor you need to put inductor, and for the inductor you need to put capacitor, for the resistor also you need to put the conductance. So in which way we will see now. So in the for the second case here you can observe, this is the case R1, L and R2 and I and C. What is the first step? Place the nodes in each loop and the reference node outside. And next, drawing the lines connecting the nodes passing through each element, and placing the dual of each element by taking or drawing the network circuit elements. So in which way you can draw? Here this is the total circuit diagram. That means in which way you can draw? That means here, first of all, what you need to do? Here you need to put two loops he has given. For these two loops, you need to put, for one loop, you can draw one dot, and for the second loop, you can draw one dot. And next, for these two corresponding nodes, you need to draw outside also one reference node. So here you can observe the final network. What is the final network you can observe? Here you can see here, for the first loop, we have drawn one node, and for the second loop also, you have drawn one node, and for the third node also, you have drawn one node. That means here, after that, what you need to do for each element, for each node and for each element, you need to connect. Okay, connection. And for the internal node, here you can observe the current source. From the current source, what is the current source? For the current source is with respect to the reference node and the first loop. So that's why it has to be between the internal first internal node and the reference node. And the dual element of the in this current source will be given by voltage source. So that's why here you need to draw you need to draw like this. So here I am replacing. So that means here by means of drawing I am seeing. Okay, here one node, here one node, here one node. You need to put. For this current source, you need to put one voltage source, you need to put, okay, for this current source. And next, one more thing he has given, here the resistor he has given. For the resistor also, you need to put like this. Resistor dual, what is the resistor dual element? Conductor. So that's why here the it will be the G1. And next, for the this is for up to first loop. And for the second loop, whatever the second loop, here also, whatever the second loop is here. What is the second loop here? Resistor R2 is there, okay, resistor R2 is there, resistor R2 also, resistor R2 will become G2, okay, resistor R2 will become G2. And next, one more here, what is the, here the inductor is there, inductor will become the capacitor here, okay. And next, commonly, and that means for the first loop has been over and for the second loop has been over, and remaining what is the element? Capacitor is there. This capacitor also will be connected. This capacitor will be converting into this is both related to both elements now. So that's why you need to draw this capacitor between the two nodes. Okay, between the two nodes means here. Between the two nodes means here. But capacitor element, which is the capacitor element? Dual element, inductor now. So that's why here. That means like that. Okay, inductor. And next, you need to recombination. Okay, recombination is here you need to draw properly. So, in which way? Here you can observe this one here like this. Okay, like this I have written. So, that means for each loop, you need to draw one node and first node and second node. And corresponding to those two nodes, you need to draw one reference node. And then after that, for the current source, you need to draw one voltage source, and like that I have given. And next, for the resistor R1 also, you can draw for the G1. That is the first loop over. And next, coming to second loop, what are the elements? For the inductor, you can draw the capacitor. And for the resistor R2, you can draw the G2. And second loop also over. And next, what is the remaining element? Remaining element is capacitor. Capacitor is between the two loops, so that's why here also the capacitor should be between the two nodes. It has to be between the two nodes. So but the dual element of that capacitor is nothing but our inductor. So that's why you need to replace here this one. This is the total circuit redrawing. So by means of this, simply if you redraw this network, okay, if you redraw in this network, all the series elements will be going to be parallel elements, all the mutual elements is going to be mutual mesh elements will be going to be mutual nodal elements, that means inductor. Here like this way you can observe here the current source has become voltage source, and next R1 will become G1, and next capacitor is between the two nodes, so that's why capacitor will become inductor. And next here the inductor the R2 will become G2, and next inductor will become the capacitor. This is the network dual elements. And it's coming to the next network. What is the next network? Here he has given that draw the dual for the network given. 10 voltage source he has given, and it's 5 Henry he has given. 2 more he has given. That means conductance he has given. That means for this conductance you need to draw the resistance. And it's 5 farad capacitor he has given, and it's 1 ohm he has given. So for this one you need to draw the dual of the network. What is the procedure? First we will discuss the procedure. What is the procedure here? Procedure simply. First of all, what you need to do here? There are two loops now. For these two loops, what you need to do? First of all, you need to put two dots. Okay, you need to put two dots for these two loops. And after that, around this loop, what you need to put one reference node also. You need to put, and then after that, for each element, you need to draw the dual elements. For the voltage source, you need to draw the current source. And for the inductor, you need to draw the capacitor. And for the two more, it is between the two loops. But here, two more has to be converted into two ohm resistor. And that should be between the two nodes. And next, 5 farads is between the second node and the reference node. And here 1 ohm is also between the second node and the reference node. That means in which way here it will be like this. Okay, like this means here, just I will show, just wait, here like this. That means here for these two nodes you need to draw like this. Okay, here this is like this. I need to, first of all, what you need to do, first of all you need to draw the dots. That means you need to put nodes. And then after that, for this voltage source, for this 10 voltage source, it will become the current source. Okay, it will become the current source. And after that, for this inductor will become the capacitor. And first loop has been over. And next, this 1 ohm resistor will become one more conductance. And next here, 5 farad will become 5 inductor. Okay, 5 inductor units are henries, 5 henries. And next here, last one only, two more conductance has been given now. That will be between the, this is mutual to both two loops. So that's why here this should be converting into like this. Okay, kata. Like this way you need to go. So here recombination you need to do. Okay, recombination. What is the recombination here? I have written like this. That means like this you can draw. Okay. So simply what you can take here simply. That means whatever may be the connection, that elements between the two nodes are there. Between the two nodes, all the elements will be replaced. Current voltage source has been become current source, and inductor become capacitor. And first you need to see first loop, and second you need to see second loop, and then after that the mutual elements you need to see. Okay, that is the procedure. And this is the connection, and by recombining here this will be like that. Okay, that means whatever may be the element, series elements will be going to parallel, and the parallel elements going to be series. Okay, this is where you need to go. So these are the dual concept, dual and duality. Here in this class we are discussing about the reciprocity theorem, compensation theorem, and dual terms and the duality elements. In the next class we will discuss the extra problems related to all the theorems. Thank you.